Hey folks, welcome back to Maverick Gunworks. Today we're going to do a little bit of a troubleshooting, I guess you'd say, and an introduction to the Browning Auto 5, or A5 as most people will call it. Here we have the Browning Light 12 A5, and this one is, thankfully, let's spin it around here, we can see it a little better. Right up here on the barrel, you can see this one is made in Belgium. Quite a treasure. These are really neat guns in it that pretty much last forever, guys. They can be rebuilt and restored. We do a lot with restoration on these, re-blueing, that kind of thing. Anyway, with this one, to do a quick overview, I guess, of how to clean the gun, start with, we're going to run a solvent patch through the barrel and also inside the chamber here where we can get to. We'll let that set for a few minutes and come back with a couple of clean dry patches to clean out all the debris that the solvent has dissolved for us. Then we'll finish it up with a lightly oiled patch, being sure not to leave it too wet. We know that the wet surface will attract dirt, so we want to leave just a thin film of oil on it. And on this gun, if you want to do a deeper cleaning, I guess you'd say on any shotgun really, but especially on the Browning A5, to remove the trigger assembly to be able to access all the internal parts in here, we would end up removing our lock screw here. Let's get a little pointer here, maybe that'll help. Here's our lock screw, and this is our buttstock screw. We would take this screw out, which, by the way, you will need a very thin blade screwdriver for these. Other Browning screws are very thin, slotted. So I know here at our shop we have a set of screwdrivers made specially for the Browning shotguns. You remove that screw, the buttstock would come off the gun. Then you will be able to remove the locking screw, which this is missing already. We've told the customer about that. We're missing a lock screw here and a lock screw here. Then we'll remove the rear and the front trigger group screw. All right. Once we take those screws out, we'll be able to remove the whole trigger group from the frame of the gun, from the receiver. At that point, you go in and clean everything up, re-lube it, and put it back together. One thing I caution you about, if you want to do this on your own at home, that's something to be careful of, is the spring. There's a leaf spring that is attached to the inside of the trigger group. If that spring is not positioned just right when you put it back in, the gun's not going to cycle correctly. So something to be cautious of. Make sure you're aware of how the positioning is on the springs and what parts they have to put pressure on when you put the trigger group back into it. All right. Now, as far as facing the issue of what this gun was brought in for. Oh, that's another thing I want to mention too with this gun. We have this lever right here. I didn't mention that a while ago. This is a shell cutoff lever, which gives us the ability to be able to open the bolt, empty the shell from the chamber, and with this lever down, we can leave our magazine tube cartridges in a magazine without having to make the gun safe, without having to remove all the ammo from the from the magazine. Right. So anyway, just another tidbit about the A5. With this one not cycling completely when he was using very light bird loads, he was using number 8 loads that are designed for skeet and trap shooting. And what we found out is, with the action on this gun, the barrel floats. I'll say it moves. The barrel recoils when you fire the gun. And that's controlled by a large recoil spring that's on your magazine tube. We're going to take this apart and take a look at it and see if we have what kind of, it feels stiff to me, but we're going to look and see what kind of situation we have with this spring and the bronze friction ring and bushing on it. So we'll take our fore end off, pull our barrel off, and now, what I see right offhand on this one is the issue very well could be the fact that this is heavy lubrication on here. It's very stiff. This friction ring, which is a bronze friction ring, and it's surrounded by a metal locking band around the bronze friction ring. This is pretty stiff. It don't move very well. It's because the lubrication on here is either dried out or it's very stiff to start with. This is almost dry. The tube here is almost gooey, so there's not much lubrication on here to allow it to cycle correctly. Also, when we have the friction ring. This metal band here is a friction ring. That is in the wrong position for actually for light loads. We're going to remove our bronze friction ring. Okay. And we'll take off our metal friction ring. If we look at this, we have a cupped or beveled side and a flat side. We always want to put these back on the gun with the flat side facing the spring. All right. And in this situation, the our way to arrange these guns for light loads will be to remove this spring. We're going to position our friction ring with the bevel side facing the receiver and the flat side facing against the spring again. And you see here, and as I remove the spring, you can see the spring. I can lay it on again a table maybe against the magazine tube. This spring is arched, so at some point this spring has been overstressed or maybe bent at some time and somebody tried to straighten it back out. We're hoping that's not going to be an issue. We'll know when we do a final testing on it. But as we have this gun apart, we're going to clean the old lubrication, relube it with some lightweight oil and or some grease, replace our spring, replace our friction ring, and put it back together. We'll test fire it after that. But anyway, that just gives you a few tips about the tuning of the Browning A5. These guns can actually be tuned depending on where you position your friction ring and the heavy or light lubrication you use on your magazine tube. So anyway, maybe that helps some guys if you're having this kind of situation. If you're ever in the middle of North Carolina, come and check us out at Maverick Gun Works.